We're going to be talking about what the crucial elements are of a great swing. We're not going to talk about mental game. We're not going to talk about preparation. We're going to talk about the physical swing. This is a topic that so many people ask me all the time in DMs and on my Facebook page. They're like, what are the little things that like make up a great swing? And I'm going to share with you the most important things that create a great swing. Fun fact, by the way, because we're going to talk about the swing, is my actual logo for my Ashley Burkhart training brand is my swing. So if you guys look at that swing, it's not just something I found on the internet, it's my physical swing. I had a friend of mine edit my senior poster from Purdue, and she like outlined the entire swing and like these laser beams that we attached to my bat, and it made like almost looks like Saturn's rings around my swing. She like edited that and made that. So that's the actual logo. It's my actual swing, and I spent, you know, 23 years of my life, not 23, because that would mean that I've been working on my swing since I was 0 years old. But I would say at least, 18 years of my life, I dedicated to making that swing perfection. And when I gained that confidence in my swing, that confidence resonated into my actual swing come game time. So 18 years of my life, at least, I devoted to my swing to make it look good. And one of the compliments that I used to love when people like would look at my swing, they'd be like, wow, it's so pretty. How can I swing like that? And I'm like, it just takes time. It takes time to perfect. And the elements that I'm gonna give you today are gonna help you get to have a great swing, a beautiful swing. We talk a lot about mental game, and we know that like without a good, strong, confident mind, your swing means nothing, but your swing does matter. Especially when we're at contact. You know, these MLB players, they fly around with their hands, they do this really wacky like thing before they actually create their swing, but at contact, they're all in the same position. So we're going to talk about that position that they're in today, because it's very important to know and feel yourself in that position. Let's start with some positivity. I got home from our trip this past week, and my boyfriend had left me this giant Portillo's chocolate cake. And you guys from Florida and Missouri may not know what Portillo's is, but it was one of my favorite restaurants of all time in Chicago, and their Portillo's cake, it's like this big and round and like this tall, and it is freaking amazing. So that was like his Valentine's Day gift to me, because I wasn't here on Valentine's Day, but I have a massive Portillo's cake that I can't wait to dive into after dinner today. That's my positivity of the day. Hat of the day. I wear a hat for every single live. So this one's actually from my boyfriend. He caddied for his best friend, Adam Shank, on the tour, and he's sponsored by Mizuno. So that's my hat of the day. With that, let's dive into this topic about hitting, because you guys know how much I love hitting and how much I love seeing your young athletes or athletes that are here, seeing your swing develop. And I want to share with you some of the signatures that make a great swing. But before I do that, I want to talk about the elements that aren't crucial to having a good swing. And it's important to do this because so many people, they wrap their heads around and their minds around all the things that don't actually matter when it comes to the swing. And those things are things like this. Anything before your positive movement to a pitch. So anything like when you're standing in the box, wiggling around your bat, or even getting to that loading position, like anything before all of that movement doesn't matter. Like it doesn't matter, you know, if you fling your bat like this, or if you, I don't know, do a couple squats or do like an Anthony Rizzo, like a hip thrust. Like he does some like wacky stuff before he swings. But that's not stuff that's crucial to have a great swing. That's just something that's like a signature for those athletes that they like to do and it makes them feel good. Another thing is anything that happens after you get through the ball into extension. And if you guys have been here before, extension is basically when you're through the pitch and your arms are completely through and almost completely straight after you've made contact. After you're at that extension point, you can do and create whatever flair you want to your swing. I mean, shoot, if you want to end at extension and finish there, you can. Or if you want to get to extension and then just let your arms finish, just like I do, you can do that too. But anything after extension, it doesn't matter. I'm saying this because a lot of people put so much emphasis on, you know, how big their swing is when they finish that they focus on the finish instead of the dirty work that's actually getting to and through the ball. So quit focusing on, you know, what does my finish look like? It looks so pretty. Like, yeah, I like the compliment of people saying my swing's pretty. But they're probably just looking at the aftermath. And if people are trying to create the aftermath, they're not actually working on the things that matter. The things that matter are what I'm about to tell you after this last thing that doesn't matter. And that's your routine before hitting. A, as long as you have a routine, you're good. It doesn't matter what you do in your routine. So what I mean by that is, as you have to have a routine. You have to have some sort of routine that gets you in the right headspace before you swing. And like I said earlier, we're not talking about the mental game today, but you do need a good routine. But one thing that you don't need is to have a routine like somebody else. So don't think that because so-and-so plays with their gloves or because so-and-so grabs some dirt and throws it before they're a bat that you have to do those things. You don't have to do anything that you don't want to do. When it comes to your routine. Your routine is your own flair, like I said before. It's your own signature. So don't feel like you have to do the things that certain people are doing in their routine. As long as you have a routine and you love it and it makes you feel good, that's all that matters. The things that are crucial to having a great swing are these. And I'm gonna get pretty specific. So if you guys wanna write these things down, I would highly recommend it. So you can start looking for these things in your swing or maybe in swings that you watch professional or even college players right now doing. These are the specific things that at contact, every single elite athlete does. So even Hunter Pence, who has this wild swing, he has this crazy swing, but I'm telling you right now, he compares to the highest level hitters that have beautiful swings when it comes to what's happening at contact. So at contact, these are the crucial elements. First, having a strong front leg. What I mean by that is at contact, so you've already approached the ball, your hands, this is another thing I was gonna say, your hands are above your barrel at contact, even on a high pitch. You can't have a strong front leg and still be on your tiptoe at contact. Your feet can't be like this. Your heel has to be into the ground and grounded and strong, almost like the brakes to a car that have to stop your momentum. Because in order to use the ground the way your body is meant to use the ground in your swing, you have to be able to have a strong front leg so it can hold that power and make sure that power is going into the ball instead of pushing your power into your front leg and you're standing on your front leg only. Focusing on having your front leg strong, you're gonna be able to have the center of your body at a crucial contact point and being balanced. So I actually, you know what I should do is pull up a picture. So you know what, I'm just gonna pull up my logo. But I will actually just show you. I'm wearing sweatpants, but it doesn't matter. Okay, so when it comes to this position, at contact, you wanna have your body in the center of your legs. So in order to be at contact and be super balanced, you can't have weight on your front leg. You can't have weight all the way on your back leg or you're not balanced. So in order to get to a good contact position, you have to have your weight in the center of your body. And in order to do that, your front heel has to be down. And most of your weight, like if you feel the pressure on any part of your body, it's like on your back big toe. And the reason why it's on your back big toe and not on the outside of your foot is because you want that power to go in one direction in your actual swing. So if your power is trying to go up the middle and you have your weight on the outside of your back leg, your knee is now going away from you, which means your power will go away from you. I hope this is making sense. So we want that power to be directly going up the middle, which leads me to my next point. The next thing that's super crucial to having a strong swing is making sure that that power is going up the middle. So in order to do that and to be balanced, I like to make my feet not go outwards like this, so my toes are like going like a penguin. We wanna be almost like a pigeon. So pigeon toe, they say bring your toes in a little bit, and I'm not saying like you want your feet like this, that's not true. So if this is a like completely straight foot, just bring your toes in just a little bit, and that's gonna actually allow your knees to go inside your feet. So in order to create that balance and in order to use the ground, you want your weight to be on the inside of your feet in order to make that happen. My knees are now here and I'm almost like bending and my knees are under me. And you want your knees under you in order to hit and to have power because you're using the ground when you swing. If my knees were flared outward, my power is now in my like backside only and my posture is not where I want to be. But if your knees are actually under you, my chin is now going to line up with my knees and now I'm in a position, a hinged position, that's gonna allow me to get to the ball really, really well. I need to have my chin almost in, like right in line with my knees. I can't have my weight here. I'm not gonna be able to get through the ball. Having your knees inside your feet is super, super crucial so you can get to the ball and get over it. Now, at contact. So if I'm headed to the ball, I need to make sure that at contact, my hands are above my actual barrel. So my barrel is probably gonna be in a position like this at contact, even if it's on a high pitch, even if it's on a low pitch,
my hands have to be above the ball. Because if my hands somehow get below the ball, or even if this is the line of the ball, if they get below it at any point in time, that ball is shooting straight up in the air, or you're getting under it and you're missing it completely. So make sure that you guys realize that when you're swinging and your swing path is going to the ball, if your hands get under the ball at any point in time, do not expect to hit a hard line drive. Do not expect to hit it over the fence. In order to hit the ball hard, your hands have to be above that actual ball at contact. So if my hands are here and the ball's here, I'm in a good spot. But as soon as my hands from starting point to finish go under the ball, I am now getting under the ball with my actual contact and the ball will flare up. So focus on keeping your hands above the ball. Your barrel will actually line up almost like on a line here to be able to get to a strong contact position. Now, let's talk about our elbows, okay? So at contact, if your elbows are clenched together like this, you're not gonna be able to get completely through the ball and get a good barrel on the ball because you wanna be loose and whippy through the ball. But if your elbows are here, you're kinda stuck and you're not gonna be able to get that back elbow to extend and get powerfully through it. So at contact, my elbows are kinda separated. So they always talk about like the 90 degree angle. So if I have my elbows in my actual contact position, I'm just gonna turn from here. They're kind of in like a 90 degree angle, like this. So there's space between my elbows. I have to be able to create that space so that I can extend my elbows through the ball and get through every single ball that I make contact with. So getting through the ball and getting to that extension that I was talking about earlier, once I'm here at contact, oh yeah, this is a way better angle. I don't know why I didn't do it before. Once I'm here at contact, I'm not quite done. So I need to make sure that when I get through it, my elbows are now straight, and now that power that I've really worked hard on to drive with my legs is now finishing through the ball with my arms, and then I can add whatever flare I want to at the end. So making sure our elbows are separated, I'm nice and strong here so that I can get through the ball later. It's gonna allow that loose and whippy snap of that barrel to be fast at the point where I need it to be fast at contact, so I can get through the ball. So those are some crucial elements that come down to just making sure that you are strong with your legs and loose with your arms. I'm just gonna go over the things that I've talked about so far when it comes to what are crucial at contact. Weight at contact is on your back big toe because you're pushing and you're driving the ground away from your back leg, especially the inside of your foot. The weight is in the center of your body at contact, so you don't want your weight flaring this way. You don't want your weight flaring this way because then I'll be on top of it and just drive a ball into the ground and nobody actually wants that. Nobody wants a choppy ground ball. If I'm gonna get through a ball, I need to make sure my power is right over my back knee. So I love describing this one. I'm gonna stand up for this one too. So at contact, my back knee and my eyes and my nose are actually like on a straight line. So that's actually saying that my power right now is in the center of my body just like I was talking about. So if those are lined up, I'm in a really good, powerful position to be able to get through the ball. Pretend like I'm a mirror, or I have a mirror right in front of me right now. If I'm at contact and my weight's on my front foot, that's where the ground balls happen. But if I'm at contact and I'm way back here, that's where the fly balls happen, because now my hands are going in a direction up through the ball instead of being strong and getting down through the ball here. So you want to be able to be centered. You want your head to be over your back knee so you can get through the ball. I'm going over so many things, but I hope you guys are picking up on some of this. Make sure your hands are above the ball the entire time in order to get all of it, and having a very strong front leg. So think about all of this power that we're developing in our load and then exploding into the actual ball. There's a lot of power and there's a lot of momentum going into that pitch. But if we don't have a strong front leg, all of that momentum is not going where we want to. It's actually just like swaying into our front leg. We don't want to sway our power into our front leg. We want to be able to stop the brakes with our front leg so that we can use the ground to help create torque to help us get to that ball extra, extra fast. We talked about pigeon toe, making sure your toes, instead of being completely straight or outward, because that means our knees are going to go in an outward position, bringing our toes in so that we can have our knees and our weight inside our feet. That's where we want to be to create the most power. And the last thing is, this is a cue that I like to say to my hitters so that they can actually get that power and their energy inside their feet instead of going outward, is to focus on kind of feeling like we're splitting the floor. When you do that, your weight is on the inside of your feet. And when your weight's on the inside of your feet, so are your knees. So if you're trying to split the floor and like actually use the inside, you're now almost like on a block on that back foot. You know how like Usain Bolt and all these sprinters and track runners, in order to create explosion on their first step, they're on a block to help them push off? Think about that. If you're putting your weight on the inside of your back foot, you're now on a block that you can drive and you can push that power into the ball. So think about that back foot almost being like you're splitting the floor, your weight's on the inside of your feet, so then you can use your back foot as almost like you're going off a starting block, you're driving your hips, your hands are still back, so that once your hands whip through, it's a fast and it's a straight motion.
This is stuff where I just like flew through this entire topic in like 10 minutes, but it's because I'm passionate about it and I get really excited about hitting, because there are so many elements that the best hitters have that so many people, because the swings are happening so fast, like when you watch an MLB hitter like swing, it looks like you only see the start and the finish. Like all the things that are happening in the middle are sometimes overlooked because of how fast it's happening. All the fastest part of your actual swing is happening straight in the middle, like right at contact. So in order to get to a good position, one of my good friends, Ryan Fuller, he posts so many pictures and videos of baseball and softball players hitting. So if you follow him at Fuller Hitting on Instagram, he has such good insight and pictures and like actual visuals so that you can see where the best hitters are actually at contact. One more thing that I'm going to mention when it comes to like the mirror that we were talking about. So at contact, we wanted to look like we were at a really specific position, with our hands above the ball, our weights in the center of our body. But that's actually a drill that you can do from the comfort of your own home. So a lot of people, they have like long mirrors in their house, right? Like I actually don't have one, but like most people do, so I'm the weird one. But like a long mirror where you can see from like head to toe your entire body. And like if you guys are my mirror, I would simply line up my body like to be there to where I can see my feet, I can see my head. And then I would just practice getting into a rhythm of getting to this position. So strong, my head's over my back foot, check my hands, make sure they're above the ball. I have a good gap between my elbows, my weight's in the center, I have a strong front leg, and just doing this. Like literally, you can do this every single day for like 5 minutes. If you do that, I'm telling you right now, you're gonna have rhythm that you've always wanted as a hitter. Load, attack. Make sure I'm in the center of that mirror. Load, I'm away from the mirror, attack, I'm in the center of the mirror. If you see that your weight's back here, you're in the wrong spot. If you see that your weight's right here, you're in the wrong spot. So make sure you line up yourself with the center of the mirror and practice those swings. And you're gonna have extremely good rhythm, and you're going to have kind of just like this like outside look of what you look like. And I know that sounds weird, but I am a visual learner. Like I wanna be able to see where my body's at in a certain position so that I can create that position over and over and over and to be able to do it for every single swing that I take. So if you are a visual learner like me, that mirror drill that you can do from the comfort of your own home, like you don't need an actual bat to do it, you guys will seriously see huge benefits in your swing. Even college athletes, like I've seen so many facilities with college athletes and they have like a mirror just in the corner when a player needs to check where they're at. They need to check where their body positioning's at. So don't think that it's just something that youth athletes should be doing. This is stuff that like MLB players, college players, all of these players are doing it because it works. So that mirror drill is something that could be crucial that you should just add to your nightly routine. 5 minutes a night, imagine how much confidence you're gonna develop in that actual positioning of where you are at contact. You're going to literally see your swing flourish if you start doing those types of things. I wanna answer this question because it just popped up. Destiny just asked, looking for language to talk to girls who are developing a golf swing versus staying on plane with the ball. Okay, this is actually really, really good. I love this because it's funny because in high school, I had like this definitive swing that I've always had, but people are like, wow, it looks like it's a golf swing. And in reality, like I've started practicing golf like later in my career, like starting in college, and I did it on the opposite side. So like I swing left-handed in softball. So in golf, I picked it up on the right side just to be sure that I wasn't creating bad habits for my actual swing. But there are so many similarities, but so many differences in those two swings that I really think it's awesome that Destiny just asked this question. When it comes down to it, think about this. When we hit off of a tee in softball, it's kind of similar to a golfer like hitting off of a tee. The similarities of that are the fact that you're making contact outside of the center of your body. So in either of those actual sports, like you're not hitting the tee directly in the middle, it's kind of out in front just a little bit so you can get behind it. But what's similar is the fact that you do want to get behind your actual contact point in both. And one thing that I actually forgot to mention earlier is your eyes always need to be behind the ball at contact. So if you're actually making contact in the center of your body right here and your eyes are here, you're not able to see the path of the ball and the actual contact point being made. So if you're noticing that like you're getting behind the ball or you're missing balls a lot of times it's because you're not tracking the ball to your actual bat. And in order to do that, we need to see where it's coming from and where we're making contact. Definitely got off on a tangent when it came down to that, but make sure your eyes are behind the ball at all times. But what's similar of the two swings is that you're hitting it in the same spot, like a little bit out in front of you. But the differences between golf and softball is that in golf, at contact, you're supposed to be in a rolled over position because the actual head of your club is making contact at the rolled over position like this with our hands. But, and this is why I struggled so much with golf when I first started, is because I got inside everything in golf. Because in softball, my hand positioning at contact, I have to have my palms palm up, palm down, and I will not roll over until I'm actually through it and through that extension point. So once I'm actually through the ball and my hands are extended, then I can roll over. But what's happening in golf is that at contact, they're already at extension. Which, if a lot of players are having these golf swings, it's because their hands are going too low and they're allowing their rollover position to be here instead of after contact, here, then you roll over. I'm gonna give you a drill right now to work on this with those athletes. Is at contact, have a tee lined up just like in a normal position. My contact's gonna be made out in front. And what they can do is that they can go in slow motion. So allow their front heel to land, their legs to start turning, their hands to go to the ball, and I want them to get to a really nice position, focusing on palm up, palm down at contact, eyes behind the barrel, and from that position, they're actually going to leave their legs exactly where they were at, and they're going to move their hands on a straight path back to where they started, back here, and then what they're going to do is they're going to unleash their hands and hit through the entire ball. So they're not using their legs. They may have a little bit of torque left with their strong legs that are on the ground, but a good positioning drill to make sure their hands are in a good spot and a palm up, palm down position and not rolled over at contact like a golfer is to focus on this palm up, palm down. I'm at contact. I'm coming back nice and slow, leaving my legs completely still. It's like they're in the cement, and then I'm gonna get through the ball and allow my hands to whip through the ball fast. So that's a really, really good drill that you can use with your hitters to make sure that they're getting on plane with the ball and through the ball. One thing that players like to do when they do that drill, once they get to contact, they'll like swoop their hands down and bring them back up. But if we create that habit and go from down to up, we're gonna go right back where we started and go down to up. So focus on a flat plane, almost like I'm pulling back a rubber band on a straight path. So then I can go through the ball on the actual swing. So that's gonna help with hand path as well. So whether it's you, whether it's your daughter, whether you're a coach that has a bunch of athletes that need things to learn from, this is probably one of the most insightful lives that I've done. Like I literally hammered like all of the elements that create a great swing to check in on yourself to make sure you're doing these things so you can become the best hitter that you can be. But just really quickly, I'll go over the things that at contact you want to have. You want to have a strong front leg. You want to have your hands above the ball and your eyes behind it. The weight is in the center of your body at contact. Your weight's going to feel like it's on your back big toe. And because of that, your back knee and your eyes or your head are going to be on a plane, on a straight line together. Your weight is always inside your feet, so you can use the ground to really get into the ball. And a cue that you can use to help create that is to say, split the floor. Split the floor with your feet so you can get on the inside of your feet and have the most power come contact. With that, that's pretty much all I have. But if you guys saw earlier on my social media platforms, I am launching something pretty exciting. And because of that launch, it's happening on March 1st, which is the anniversary of when I launched online training last year. Online training is getting a brand new facelift. So I'm going to be starting to have courses where, when it comes to the physical game and the mental game, two courses that you can take or your daughter can take to develop confidence in themselves and develop physical aspects of the swing. So there's going to be a hitting section, there's going to be a mental section. But they're courses to develop your confidence over time and also your physical and mechanical swing over time. So that's what I'm going to be launching. I'm really excited because we're going to be doing an actual live where it's going to be like a huge Q&A for whoever wants to join, whoever wants to ask, what are the elements of a swing that are important? What are the physical drills that I should be doing to work on specific stuff? These are all things that are going to be in that course. So I'm super, super excited to launch this. Join us for our actual like massive live. It's going to be inside the hashtag Smash Drive Facebook group. So if you guys aren't members of that group yet, go over to Facebook, go to groups, which is under Ashley Burkhart Training, and apply. You don't have to apply, you just have to ask to join the group. You must be inside that group because that's where the live's going to be on March 1st. So it's going to be March 1st, it's a Sunday. We're going to meet from 5:30 to 6:30, so it's going to be an hour of coaching. So basically this times a million. And it's going to be super, super fun. So mark your calendars, we're going to hang out on there. If you guys have questions, shoot me a DM, but make sure that you're part of the Smash Drive group so you can be involved with all of the things that we're going to be doing. We're going to go over, you know, in the past year, what are the amazing things that we've learned from our lives, amazing content we've created, just all the things that have been going really, really awesome for Ashley Burkhart Training, making it even better come March 1st. So I hope you guys join me there. I'm really excited about it. With that, I'd love if you share this with people that might be able to benefit from it. But this was super fun, and I cannot wait till next Monday. All right, you guys, have an amazing week. See you later.